What's up, everybody, and welcome to the final episode of the My Child Lebensborn playthrough. This has been amazing. I am going to try to get through the rest of this in one go. So it's definitely going to be a longer episode, but I really hope you guys are going to enjoy it. It's been a very big emotional roller coaster, but it's also been incredible. And I think I can speak for all of us when I say that we've probably all learned a lot about this time in history, in ways that we probably wouldn't have before. But if you are new here, welcome in. My name is Shannon, or Scaredy Ginge. Thank you for coming in, and if you're returning, welcome on back. Please remember to hit that thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I will be bringing more content here soon, and it's just been wonderful. So thank you for all the support, and let's go ahead and get on into the episode. Hello, I'm awake. So I realized in the last episode that I actually never changed her clothes at all. So we're gonna do that here. So, let's see. That's what we're first going to do. Still can't believe I did that. We're going to put her, or I should say, my favorite outfit on her. Let's see. And then we'll go ahead. Hopefully there's some food. There is. Nice. I hope I learned something fun today. I'll see you soon. Learn a lot today. Don't forget anything. There you go. I'll try. Let's get just a little bit more food in her tummy. There we go. To the home we go. Karen is not home yet. Hello? Okay. I'm a little nervous right now. I'm home. I don't like staying late. Please don't touch me. Oh no. Tell me what's wrong. Oh, sorry, I won't do it anymore. Is something wrong? Is something wrong? No, nothing is wrong. Tell me what's wrong. Okay, I'll stop. You can talk to me. Nothing is wrong. Just stop touching me. Mom intuition is, kicking in right now. Big time. I want my bed. Okay. Let's see if she can let me... Yeah, no. Okay. I don't like that. Okay. Night-night. This is... I do not like this. Let's finish this off. Here I am. Good morning. The mail is here. It is. Will she let me give her... a bath? Okay. Okay, nope, she still won't let me touch her. Okay. Well, she ate all of her food and I have no more money. Let's see if she'll play ball with me. I hope I do well today. Take care. Don't be late. Take care. Okay. I don't think she should be going to school. Something's not right. It's not normal for a child to not want to be touched. What is going on? In the news, calmer times in Berlin. Tensions are decreasing after Russian forces and East German police withdrew from all the four disputed areas along the sector borders. Civilians can again move freely between East and West, bringing a great sigh of relief for all those affected. I'm home. I miss you when I stay so late. Why are you staying late? Can I touch her yet? No? Okay. Alright. Good night. You're so hungry. Okay. Well, we can... Good morning. Can we get you bathed first, maybe? Well, okay, we'll feed you. What is going on? Mr. Solheim isn't very nice. Yeah, you can go to sleep. See you tomorrow, okay. Karen, what are you still doing in bed? Morning, honey, are you okay? Good morning, ready for a new day. We will say morning, honey, are you okay? Yes. I'm okay. See, I'm up. No, still okay. We still can't touch her. In my heart of hearts, I think I know what's going on right now, and it scares me. Okay, so I can't. I baked the cake, but apparently that's gone, so we'll just get her this. I'm not hungry. You still have to eat. Let me know when you're hungry, okay? You don't want to eat? I'm not hungry. You need food. I don't need food. You can't make me. Okay. Why not? Let's see. I don't want to have a bath. Why not? Oh, okay. You have to take a bath, Karen. Why not? I don't need a bath. Tell me what's wrong now. Okay, I won't force you to have a bath. Did something happen? Nothing happened. I just don't feel like having a bath right now. I'll wash later. Okay. Okay. See if we can play some ball with her. I don't like playing anymore. Something's up. Tell me what's wrong now. Nothing is up. I just don't like playing. Why not? Which means something is up. That's simply not like you. It is now. Leave me alone. Goodness gracious. This is... okay. That's helping quite a bit. I'm trying to think of what we could do to pass the time. Do we have... oh, we have crafting materials. Okay. Time to go, isn't it? Do you want me to stay? Okay, I have to go to work, honey. Will you be okay? Do you want me to stay here today? Do you want me to stay here today? Really? You don't have to. Will you be okay if I go to work? Would you like that? We can stay in and relax. We'll do that one. Yes. You should go if you have to. Don't worry, honey. I'm here. Okay. Thank you. I don't want to eat. Okay. And I don't think she still wants to play. Yeah, playing is for kids. Alright, that's that. And then we'll just go here and fix this. I'm going to draw for a while. Great, I can help you. No, that's okay. I'm fine. Okay, I'm gonna see if there's any drawings anywhere. What? Time to eat, Karen. I want you to talk to me. Oh, nothing. I want you to talk to me. I'm busy. Go away. Yes. Time to eat, Karen? I don't feel like eating. I'm shocked. Because I don't know what to do now, like... guess I'll pick some berries. So many blueberries. Mm-hmm. It's getting late. We should head back home. You're right. We probably stayed out a bit too long. We had a lot of fun, though. I suppose. Alright, let's get you to bed. There it is. Oh, boy. Are you upset? I am upset, yes. You won't eat or wash or even play. I just want to know what's going on. I just don't know what to do. I just want to know what's going on. I'm not supposed to tell anyone. Karen, what are you saying? I'm gonna cry. I don't understand. What are you not supposed to tell anyone? I'll say that one. I'm going to sleep. Good night. Are you feeling hungry now? Will you eat today? Get up, Karen. Let's see. Are you feeling hungry now? Not really. Get up, Karen. You have to eat. I think you should eat. Could you please eat for me? Okay, I'll do it for you. Munch, munch. I'm sorry that I upset you. That doesn't matter. Tell me who hurt you. Was it Solheim? It's not your fault. Please tell me what happened. You shouldn't worry. What can I do to make it better? Let's see. You shouldn't worry. What can I do to make it better? We could play or something. I'm okay, really. No, you're not. You can talk to me anytime you want. I promise not to be mad. Okay, let's do something nice to take your mind off your troubles. You can talk to me anytime you want. I promise not to be mad. Okay. Nothing's wrong. I'm okay. I'm not going to worry you. What would you like to do? We could play with the ball if you want. Alright. Can I bathe you? I don't need a bath. Do you want to talk about it, honey? I think you should try, okay, for me. It's hard, but you can't avoid bathing. Do you want to talk about it? Honey, I think you should try, okay, for me. It's hard. Okay, we'll say, honey, I think you should try. Okay, I'll try. Munch, munch. I'm tired. A story before sleep would be nice. Do you have time? Of course. Nice, thank you. Alright, let's go see what this journal says. Forgive me, it's my job to take care of you, and I failed. I knew your teacher was mean to you, but never thought he was capable of such horrible abuse. Now you won't even let me hold you. We shall leave here as soon as possible. I'll do anything to make that happen. You have my word. I'm awake. I'm going to school now. What? No, you're staying here. I can't let you go back to that place. Why don't you stay home? We can play. I can't let you go back to that place. What do you mean? I can't not go to school. They'll get mad at me. What about my school? And my teacher? Forget about all that. We'll find a way to get away from this place. If anything, they should be worried about the trouble I'll cause for them. Forget about all that. We'll find a way to get away from this place. You're staying here until I find us a way out. I'm not letting anyone near you. Are you sure? Yes, you don't have to worry anymore. Okay, so I don't have to go and see Mr. Solheim? No, you never have to see him again. You don't have to do anything. I'll say no, you never have to see him again. Okay, I'll stay, please. Please, I hope this is from her father. Oh. Look at all this mail. Heinz Fleischer, I'm so sorry to hear about Karen's problems. I can wire you money that my parents left for Karen. I'm gonna cry. In exchange, you must promise not to come here or to ask for child support. My new family does not know about my child. My wife can never find out. In the news, President Truman has declared that the USA has almost finished building its first nuclear power ship. Will this mark the dawn of a new age for the United States? Will we see airplanes, power plants, and ships powered with nuclear energy in the USA? Only time will tell. What's wrong? Is it the school? How would you feel about leaving this place forever? I want you to start packing all your things. We're moving. We just got the opportunity to move somewhere new. Isn't it exciting? Let's see. How would you feel about leaving this place forever? Really? I would like that. We can move somewhere wonderful and start fresh. I found a way for us to move away. We can go somewhere better. Your father has given us money to move away from here. We can move somewhere wonderful and start fresh. Oh. So we find another house? Away from the school? But what about Liv? You can be pen pals. I'll show you how. It's fun. She's a bad friend. It's better to just leave. It might be better for her. She cares so much about being accepted here. I'll say you can be pen pals. Pen pals. Okay. I'll have to write her every day. I'll miss Liv. So are we really going? We are. Why don't you go play while I pack? Yes, have you changed your mind? Yes, let's get going. We have a lot to do. We are. Why don't you go play while I pack? I want to pack too. I'm going to pack my things. I don't want to leave my ball behind. We're packing you now, ball. Don't be afraid. We're going to go somewhere safe. I have lots of things to pack in my room too. We have to warn all my toys and things so they aren't worried. Little Fox, don't be afraid. We're packing you up now. We're going someplace safe. Wow, we had a lot of things, huh? Well, we're all packed up. Is it time for dinner? We didn't pack the food, did we? Didn't. I know we're going somewhere new and I should be happy. I'm sorry, it's all my fault. Don't say that. You are everything to me. The people here are at fault, not you. It's not your fault. There are bad people out there and close to here. Let's see. The people here are at fault, not you. Yes. Let's get you food and that tummy of yours. It's late. Are we really leaving tomorrow? Yes, I'm taking you away from these horrible people. Yes, to a new place where we won't be harassed. Yes, we'll go to a place where it's nice and safe, where no one will ever be mean again. Yes, to a new place where we won't be harassed. Are we moving to live with my dad? No, we're moving somewhere else. Not at this time. I'm sorry, Karen. No, I'm sorry, but your dad said we couldn't. I'll say not at this time. I'm sorry. Oh. Where are we going to? Will they be okay with trolls? There are no such thing as trolls. You are as human as me. Right now, anywhere is better and safe than here. We're going someplace where everyone is welcome. I promise. I'll do that one. Please don't leave me behind. Of course I wouldn't leave you. Don't worry. We'll always stay together. Never, Karen. Don't worry. We'll always stay together. Okay. You know, the king will be here tomorrow. I wanted to see him. Why on earth would you want to do that? I don't think that's a good idea. Oh, little one, kings are fun, but trains are so much better, right? Trains are cool, but the king is a real-life actual hero. If we go to the forest, we can see him without anyone noticing. No, it's out of the question. We leave in the morning. That's the end of it. It's still not safe, you or us. We'll be leaving in the morning. Fine, but we're leaving straight after. Oh, I don't know what to do here. It's still not safe for you or us, Willie, in the morning. See you tomorrow. A new entry has been placed in the journal. And there's mail. I wish to formally send my resignation. I want to thank you for the opportunity you have given me. The factory has been one of the few places that have been nice and considerate. We are moving to try and find a kinder place for Karen to grow up. Best wishes. Oops. Okay. Your father answered us. I told you the good news about the inheritance from your grandparents, which your father gave us. Forgive me for not telling you the conditions that came attached. I have to promise that I'll prevent you from visiting your father or your half-brothers in Germany. His wife doesn't know about you, and he wants things to remain that way. I must also promise that neither I nor your mother will try to claim any child benefit for you. In return, he'll send the money. I'm sorry that you won't meet your brothers, but I'm so desperate to get you away from here. I hope you can forgive me and come to understand these decisions. I ran off. I'm sorry. I wanted to see the king. Look, see, we can see everything here from the edge of the forest. This is safe. It's the right place for trolls like me. Stop it. They aren't the trolls, not you. Don't call yourself that. You are the best, most good person. We're all trolls. No one wants to admit it. That's all. Stop it. They are the trolls, not you. That doesn't make sense. I'm almost 8. I was such a baby thinking that school would be fun. Before I started school, I wanted to talk to more people, make lots of friends to play with. But most kids and adults are horrible. You wanted me to trust people, but I don't think I should anymore. Even Mr. Berg left. Maybe I can trust Liv. I trust you. I can always trust you. You found out some things about my parents. I'm a bit sad I couldn't learn more, and, well, it feels like there's some things you haven't told me. We're leaving soon. I don't want to come back. Not ever. The other place will be better, right? I'm not sure we'll be accepted anywhere in this country. We'll never give up. People will just have to accept us. We've just been incredibly unlucky. The next place will be better. We'll say that. Yes. Smile to the world and it will end up smiling back. We'll be fine. I'm still scared. You were gone so much of the time, it was scary to be alone. I hope there will be enough food in the new place. I might have to work more, but I will provide for us. We might not have much money, but I'll be there for you. Soon you're old enough to work, then it will be easier. We might not have much money, but I'll be there for you. Okay. He's here. I can hear them. We have to go see. I see the king over there. Oh, I wish we could get closer, but they would all get mad at us. At me. Everyone loves him. I want to go now. Okay, Karen, let's go. You and Karen moved to a different region of Norway, hoping the new place would be better. We don't know what happened there. If you were lucky, oh gosh, I'm crying. If you were lucky, Karen could have a better childhood. If not, history would repeat itself. There are many horrible destinies among these children. Most of them lost all faith in people, in God, and in the Norwegian government. Tove Leila, born 1941. Oh, goodness. My mother beat me. When my stepfather tried to choke me and abuse me, I ran away to some nice neighbors. They had seen how I lived and decided to protect me. Thorleif, born 1942, I had my mother, even though she had to send me to a children's home for a while because she remarried, it ended up okay for me. Gerd, born 1942, my childhood was very difficult. I understood early that I had to get away from Norway and the stigma. Joran, born 1943, we who are still alive are the lucky ones. It went badly for so many. I had my great aunt. Every child should have someone like her. trying not to cry. I'm sorry. So if you didn't catch on to what happened to her, she was assaulted by her teacher. I think it was just by her teacher. I don't know if it was anybody else. And that was the final straw, basically, for that. It's such a sad story, especially because it's true for so many of them. Sorry. We just have to hope that history doesn't repeat itself. But I want to thank you to everyone who has come through and watched this whole playthrough, and has been here for the premieres and for this one. It means a lot to me. Whew. I can't stop crying. I didn't expect this to be such an emotional roller coaster, but unfortunately it was. And again, you know, this was all pretty much what happened to the Lebensborn children, unless they were, you know, the few lucky ones. But I did hope, or I do hope, that you learned from this, and I hope that you can find it in your heart to be a little more kind to those around you. Oh boy. Because you never know what they're going through. So, with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and end it here. If you haven't already, subscribe, and if you liked the series and you liked this video, please, please do hit the like button and share this with your friends and your family, and make sure to check out the Children Born of War project. It's a wonderful project, and yeah, so thank you guys again. I hope to see you again in future playthroughs of games. Thank you for all the support, and I will catch you guys again soon. Bye.